Welcome to TheraPlanet channel. In this video, we are going to talk about what's the difference between rabbits and hares. Hares and rabbits look similar, and some may hop to the conclusion that they're the same animal, but there are distinctive differences between these cousins. Separating the two can be done by looking at the differences in size, life history, and preferred habitat. In general, rabbits are smaller and have shorter ears than hares. They are born without fur and with closed eyes after a gestation period of 30 to 31 days. Rabbits prefer to hide, rather than run, from their enemies. They prefer habitats composed of trees and shrubs, where they live in burrows dug into the soil. Hares, in contrast, are larger, and they are born fully developed with fur and open eyes after a gestation period lasting about 42 days. They are runners, preferring open area habitats such as prairies, where they make their nests in small open depressions. So what is the difference between rabbits and hares? Let's dive in. Before continue this video, please hit subscribe button first, so you know when we launch new videos. Where did the word rabbit come from? Until the 18th century, rabbits were called conies, based on the French canille, shortened from the Latin cuniculus. Rabbit first referred to the young of conies until eventually the word took over in popularity. Incidentally, that's also the origin of the name Coney Island, or Rabbit Island, the beachside amusement park in New York. It is one of the only references to coney that's still used in North America. Where did the word hare come from? The word hare is a very old one in the English language. Developing from the Old English hara, hare is recorded before 900. The deeper roots of hare are Germanic in origin, compare the Danish word hare. Hare is related to the Dutch haas and German haes. The Old English hasu, meaning gray, may be connected to hare. Where did the word bunny come from? So, what about bunnies, and specifically the Easter bunny? Bunny was originally, and sometimes still is, used as a term of endearment for a young girl. Over time, it started to mean a young and or small animal, and now it usually means a rabbit. Baby hares, called leverets, are born looking like miniature version of their parents, fully furred, eyes open, and pretty much ready to begin hopping around. They are able to live on their own only an hour or so after being born and are weaned somewhere within 2 to 3 weeks. Baby rabbits, called kits or kittens, conversely, are born hairless, blind, and helpless, and they need the attentions of their mothers for about 8 weeks. Generally speaking, hares are larger than rabbits and have longer ears and legs. They are also faster runners, which makes sense since they live in open spaces, like prairies, and need the speed to outrun predators. Rabbits and hares also have different diets, with rabbits preferring grasses and vegetables with leafy tops, such as carrots, and hares enjoying harder substances like plant shoots, twigs and bark. Differences in physical features. There are several differences in the physical features of hares and rabbits that allow us to distinguish between the two. Appearance. Hares have black markings on their fur. At birth, rabbits are altricial, their young are born blind and hairless. In contrast, hares are generally born with hair and are able to see, precocial. Young hares are therefore able to fend for themselves very quickly after birth. A young hare is called a leveret and a young rabbit is called a kitten, kit, or, least correct but very commonly, a bunny. Hind legs. Hares have very long and strong hind legs, more so than rabbits. Hair, fur. Rabbits and hares both molt and then grow new hair. This happens in both spring and in fall. Rabbits' brown summer fur is replaced with fur that is more gray. Hares, especially those living in cold, snowy regions, turn white in the winter. Hunters say that hare has a much stronger, gamier flavor than rabbit, which actually does taste like a milder version of chicken. Tails. Both rabbits and hares have short tails. Comparison of lifestyle and behavior. Hares have not been domesticated, while rabbits are often kept as house pets. All rabbits, except the cottontail rabbit, live underground in burrows or warrens, while hares live in simple nests above the ground, as does the cottontail rabbit. Rabbits also have their litters underground. Hares rely on running rather than burrowing for protection. Rabbits are very social animals and live in colonies. Male rabbits even fight within a group to become the dominant male. The dominant male rabbit then mates with most of the females in the area. On the other hand, hares live most of the time by themselves. They come together in pairs for mating only. There is almost no fighting among hares, they just pair off. Rabbits prefer soft stems, grass or vegetables. Hares eat more hard food, bark and rind, buds, small twigs and shoots. Similarities: both rabbits and hares breed prolifically, bearing 4 to 8 litters each year. A litter of rabbits generally has 3 to 8 young. They have a gestation period of about a month, are sexually mature in about 6 months, and live in the wild for about 6 years. Although rabbits and hares are valued as game by hunters both for their food and fur, they are also pests to farmers and gardeners. They can destroy crops and trees. While both rabbits and hares molt, shed their coat, when it comes to hares they generally have much more dramatic seasonal color changes than rabbits. The snowshoe hare, for instance, goes from a brown to a brilliant white come winter in order to provide camouflage appropriate to the season. In the case of rabbits, there may be some color variation between molts, but it's much less noticeable. A choice of homes is another area where rabbits and hares don't see eye to eye. Wild European rabbits live in complex burrow systems called warrens that can be close to 10 feet deep and up to nearly 150 feet long. Eastern cottontail rabbits, which range from southern Canada down to northern South America, live in dens burrowed by other species, such as woodchucks. Hares live above ground and make their homes in hollow logs or simple nests they create by tromping down grass and vegetation. Hares aren't as sociable as their rabbit cousins. Most rabbits live in groups of up to 20 individuals in what is known as a colony. Hares are generally solitary creatures but may come together during late winter and for courting purposes. The eastern cottontail, ever the contrarian, is more like a hare, preferring solitary living. Now you know, there is differences between rabbits and hares. Thanks for watching. Leave a comment, hit like button if you love this video and subscribe to support this channel.